Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. I also have a podcast where each week I cover another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. Hello and welcome. Today we're going to go over another 3D modeling tool as well as different modes that you can work within inside of your viewport. So we're going to go over reset scale. We're going to go over how to scale for an animation versus how to scale for a rigged character versus how to scale while you're 3D modeling, where you can run into some errors if you use the wrong mode. We're going to go over animation mode, object mode, and model mode, all within Cinema 4D. So let's go ahead and get started. Here we are inside of Cinema 4D. Just to quickly start off with, I'm going to go ahead and open up the asset browser right over here. And if you don't see it already, search for skeleton because I'd like to show you something once we have this skeleton open. We have a few modes here. We usually work in model mode because this is a 3D modeling podcast, but there's also object mode and animation mode. You'll need to know what these are if you ever want to animate your models that you're making here. So let's talk about this. If we were to scale this character that is fully rigged, that we got out of the asset browser in model mode, you could see that we're having some problems here. It's not scaling correct, and some odd things are happening. I'm going to hit undo. If we just click on the model though, the model scales fine. But once you add in the character into the mix and try scaling it, weird things start happening. So why is that? Well, model mode, it adjusts the axis so that it's best for 3D modeling. So this is the mode you want to be in if you were to 3D model the skeleton. If you were to scale this though, you'd really want to use object. Now, if I scale this, you can see this looks much better. It's scaling much nicer, which is good. I'll hit undo and take it back to here. So that's the way that you want to scale something that is rigged. And you can see the difference a little bit more between model mode and object mode. If we go ahead and animate a cube. I'll close out of the asset browser for right now. I'm going to add in a cube here. So we have this cube and I'm going to name this one model mode. And then we're going to duplicate this cube and we'll name our second cube object mode. And now I'm going to make both of them editable. So there we go. I hit the C hotkey. You can also hit this button down here to make both of these editable. For our object mode cube, what I'll do is I'll go over to Window, Timeline, click that right there. Now we can see our timeline. And we have our model mode cube and we have our object mode cube. I want to keyframe both of these in their current state. So I'll click on both and I'll hit this button here, which says record active objects, and it will set keyframes for both of those. If we go into our coordinates, you can see we've set keyframes for everything there. We'll go forward 30 frames. And for object mode, we are going to change into object mode to scale this. I'll hit the T hotkey in order to bring up these commands, and I'll scale this down. Once I've done that, I'll go ahead and hit record active objects again. Now for model mode, I'm going to click on this cube for model mode, and I'll go back into model mode and I'll do the same thing. I'll scale this down and I'll hit record. Now let's go back to the beginning, hit this button here to go back to the start. And you'll notice that our model mode cube is not animating, but our object mode cube is, because the object mode is designed to adjust your axis so that it will animate. But the model mode is primarily meant to be used for 3D modeling and changing how your objects look. But you don't necessarily want your changes to your model to be able to animate, so they're two different modes that handle the axis differently. And this applies also to if you want to scale anything that's made with a generator, because you can use generators for animation. So if you are 3D modeling with a generator, like the Thicken tool, and you have these all built up in a hierarchy, you're going to want to use object mode in order to fix your scaling errors. So that's the first thing to be aware of. And something else you can actually see is if I click on our model mode cube and we press play, take a look at the Y scale that I had adjusted. It's not changing. And if I adjust the Y in model mode, it's not changing. If I adjust the Y scale while in object mode, it does change. You can see here, this scale actually changed within our coordinates. If I pull this up and down, it is animating, it is recording that movement, it is changing. And if I were to hit this button here, it would record that new size that this cube is. Since I'm not hitting this button here, it won't record that change that I've done. I'll go back to the keyframed ones. So this is important to know so that you can fix your errors within your model. And let's just say we've been adjusting this one in object mode. And what if we wanted to go back to the original scale? Well, there's a tool inside of here. If we hit Shift C, you can search for it, and it's called Reset Scale. So it's for situations like this. If we press this button, it resets the scale to 1, 1, and 1. It'll go back to what it is if I hit play, unless if I keyframe this here. So I'll go ahead and hit keyframe. But now it's reset that scale to what it was originally. So that's where that comes in helpful. The reset scale is mainly for if you scaled something in object mode. You could, of course, reset these manually by just entering in 1 here. Something else to keep in mind is this third option, animation. So what does that mean? Let's open up a new scene here. I'll add in a cube. We're going to set a keyframe at 0, just where it is now. I'll go over to 30 frames, move this cube over here. I'll hit record so that we record the position of this cube. I'll move it up here. I'll actually do that closer to frame 60 though, and then we'll record that movement there. You can see we're getting this path here. So if I were to scale this in model mode that we're in right now, you know what that does. If I were to scale this in object mode right now, You could see what that does. We went over the difference between those two. If I were to scale this in animation mode right now, whoa, look at that. Our whole entire animation path is scaling. So that's what that mode is for. It scales your entire animation path. If you want to scale your keyframes, you can click on whatever you'd like to adjust, and you can click these tabs here and pull in this to make it shorter or pull them out to make it longer. And that's how you can scale those in. So we have this kind of boring animation showing this cube move. And again, if we were to scale this, it would scale that animation path. So now it's smaller, but it's not actually scaling in the cube. And that is the difference between all these different modes up here, so that you can comfortably not only 3D model, but start animating your model. So I hope you found this episode helpful. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. And I hope to see you next week here on Ambient 3D Animations.